In this video, I'm gonna try to explain how event emitters is working in the Node.js platform. If you come from a background programming, object-oriented programming, you may have heard of something called the observer pattern. And the event emitter is a kind of implementation of that pattern that's makes it easy for us that are coding in Node.js and JavaScript to use the ability to create own custom events in our modules that the user of the modules can listen to. We have earlier talked about callbacks and promise and stuff like that, and great to use when we do something asynchronous and we expect one answer once. But there can be situations where we have events that happens many times. When you come from the programming in the browser, you know, you can use the add event listener and listen to click events and stuff like that. This is some kind of way of doing this in Node.js. When different events happens, we can trigger them and let users listen to them. So in this case, I have a kind of stupid module called Home Automation. I don't think it's a module I wanna have in my home, but it simulates a kind of home automation system that works for an example for this video. So the type of the module home automation it's just an empty constructor at this moment. We have some methods. We have one method called set mode that takes a string, do a switch, and if the string is away, we calling methods bulb off, which simulates that we turn the bulb off, or maybe I should call it lamp on, I don't know. Bulb on, it's the word I'm using here. If this set mode method gets a string that doesn't have, we don't have any support for it, we're just supporting home mode and away mode in this case. In the away mode, when the user goes to the away mode, leaving the home or something, we turn all the lamps or bulbs off in the hall and in the living room, and when we get home, we turn it on in the hall and the living room. But if we try to call this with some strange string, we should have some error handling, and what I want in this case is that I want it to trigger an error event. So the one that's using this module can get an event trigger or listen to the event error to handle it in its application. If we just quickly look at the bulb on and bulb off methods, we see that when it's called creating some object that's telling what device name, the bulb name we get, and what state it's put in. Take some time, say we calling some device or something, and it takes about 1 second till we get the answer that the bulb is on or off. And then when we get that okay, this is just a simulation for this, of course, we should trigger a change event, and the same change event should be triggered when we bulb off, and of course we should send along this object to so the user knows okay, something has changed, and read in the object to see what has been changed. In this case, watch lamps or bulbs have been put on or off. Okay, so I have 3 points where I wanna trigger events in this case. So let's start to get the functionality to use this event emitter thing in this module. And the way you do it is you inherits from a type in Node.js core that it's called event emitter. So we have to do some require first of all. I'm creating a variable like this and do a require statement, and it's a core module that's called events, I'm thinking, and it's have a type defined in that module that's called event emitter like that. So that get us the type that we're gonna inherit. So we also gonna use a module that's also a pure model that can help us with inherits, and it's called util. It's a utility package that you can check out that's included in the node.js. It has some methods that can be useful sometimes. The way we do, I think you know, inheritance is we are using that make call to send this along, and we gonna do use this util, and it has a method inherits like this, and it take care of the prototype assignment and stuff like that that we usually do in when we do inherits, and it takes the event emitter. So it's gonna take and the prototype in this event emitter and put it in this module, so we get all the methods that event emitter has. And that's the methods we're gonna use when we're gonna trigger events. So if we start with this error handling first, we want to trigger, or as we call it, emit error event. So the way I do it, since we have done inherits, we can use this and use emit, and we're gonna give the error we're gonna emit. Tell what kind of event we're gonna emit. I'm gonna call it error. Maybe I should put this in a variable at the top of this module, but I'm just gonna do it like this. And we can send along some data with this, and we want the error, and I'm gonna give it non-supported mode. Like this. This row is now gonna emit an event call error and send along this error object. Okay, so if we go back to app.js, we have the module ready to go, and we can use it, and we can register to listen on the events. In the browser we often call this add event listener. In this way we have the on method. We can tell, okay, I want to listen on the error, and give it on a function that get the error as a parameter, and we can handle the error in some way. Okay, just putting out the message property. Okay, so as you see, we have the module instance, and since we inherit from event emitter, we can use the method on. Tell, okay, I want to listen to the error, I'm registered for the error event. Bind a function which takes whatever we send along. In this case, it was an error, and handle it. So we save that. I'm gonna bring up my terminal, and I think I'm in the right directory. Yes, node app.js, and we see nothing. Hmm. That's strange, yeah? Well, if you think about it, since if you look at the code in the home automation, this is pretty synchronous code, yeah? We're just gonna go in the mode and get to the default and emit. And it's nothing asynchronous about this. And as you see, okay, I'm calling the set mode. The event is emitting before we have registered the on stuff. And maybe that's not the best way. Maybe this had been better to do with a callback to avoid mixing synchronous and asynchronous programming. But to fix it in this case, we have to register the handler before, so we can listen to the event before it's emitted. This, of course, you can see that it could be problem with this, so you maybe should try to avoid it writing code like this, but to show how event emitter is working, I'm gonna do it this way. And you see, now we get the error message. We can... do it like this, and yeah, we got the error message since we have registered the call. Okay, next thing I'm gonna do, I got two to-dos here. Should trigger a change event and send along the result, of course. Well, I think you get how to do this. Emit. Okay. Emit. Change is the event name, and I realize that it's pretty stupid to do this with capital letters. In this case, I think you should always use small letters to express the event name as a standard. We emit the change and we send along the result like this. And you see this is gonna be asynchronous since we are doing this event emit in the set timeout. Gonna copy that and do exactly the same in the bulb off method. You see, it's pretty dry, this code, but it's just an example. Okay, how do we handle this in the app code? Oh, of course, we can do a register of the change event. And we have a function with a, you can call it a state. And we do console.log. I'm just gonna write that object out like that. And I have some code here. We can then call home and then call away to set different mode. We can call home again, and we can I'm gonna take this code out and we can do a set timeout. This was just before, take that away, like this. So we also have a timeout. This call is gonna wait for 5 seconds before we call set mode away the second time. So we go home and immediately we're running away, and then we get home and After 5 seconds, we get away again. So, this change event should be triggered many times. If we look, save that, and we look in the, take down that, and look in the code, we call in set mode away, okay, bulb off, hall, living room, bulb on, bulb off. We're gonna set a timeout and emit the change for every call. So when we do a set mode, we're gonna call this 2 times and get the change event 2 times. Well, let's try it. Clear node.js error. And it started to happen. We got the 3 first home, these 2, hall and living room on. We got the hall living room off, on again, and it waited for some seconds and did it off. We can maybe it's stupid to call it many times like that. Let's pretend that we first get home, and after 5 seconds we go away. I'm coming in. I take away the arrow stuff. Let's call it, well, home, the lamp took 1 second to put on, and we're waiting 5 and 1 extra second, and the states are off. So this is been called 4 times, just lying and listen to the event we have in our module. And this is how you can use the event emitter to specify own custom events for the modules to listen on, which is a good thing when we have many events going on, not just once as we are used to when we're reading files and stuff like that. So I'm gonna end it here, and you can read about the event emitters in the documentation and play around with it to figure out how to use it in different programs. But thanks for now.